Hey everyone, in this video I am going to talk about hashing data structure. Hashing is one of the most commonly used data structure in computer science, I would say. Whenever you write any code or whenever you write any program or any system that you build, any product that you build, any app that you build, you will most commonly use hashing in that. So let's jump into hashing. What hashing is? Hashing allows you to store your data in such a way so that the searches that you do on the data will be faster, or to retrieve the data later on will be faster. Hashing uses a hash function, and hash function is basically it's just a tool. So let's call it function. What this function does is it maps values from one space to another space. So let's say you have a system in which you are storing in a list of users. So for example, your user has, let's say, ID 1, name Udit. Let's say you have only ID and name, or let's say maybe designation also, maybe maybe city also. Let's say Noida. So let's say you want to store these three nodes into your system, these three entries into your system, and you want to make the searches faster. So if you do not have hashing, let's say you do not have hashing, and now you want to store these three values in your program, how will you do that? You will use a list, right? You will store these three values in a list, and you will store them sequentially. So this will be your array, a list or an array, and you will store when the item comes in. So whenever you store, whenever Udit comes in, you will store Udit over here. Then Devansh comes in, you will store Devansh over here. And then Piyush comes in, you will store Piyush over here. Now I ask you to, let's say they are also storing scores. Let's say they are playing cricket between each. I mean, they are all together playing a game, maybe Ludo, cricket or whatever game they are playing, and there is some score associated with it. So as and when each player or someone makes a move, you will have to update the score, right? So for updating the score, what you will have to do, if the score update comes for 3, you will come to this list and you will say whenever find Piyush and update the value for it, update the score for it. So you come to this guy, you say, are you Piyush? No. You come to this, Devansh, no. You come to this, Piyush, yes. So you will update the score over here. So how much time did it took to update the score for a particular user? So you, let's say this array has n elements. So you will have order of n time, right? So it will take order n time to update each of the keys. So to update a score for each of the users. So which is pretty bad. You are taking order n amount of time for updating the scores. Or what's the insertion time? Let's say array has infinite length, so insertion time will be order of 1. Since you always keep track of the first empty box, and you will just put the value over there. So order of 1 is the insertion time, and order of n is the query time. So how do we improve it? So to improve it, we need to improve the query, and to improve it, we use hashing. So what hashing will do is, we will use one of the values or one of the keys from here, which we call our identifier keys. So we can use either ID or we can also use name. And if the name is unique, we have to use some unique key so that we can identify that this is a particular entry in our hash table or whatever data structure that we use, so that we can update the value. If there is it's a 2 Piyush, then how do you know which Piyush you have to update the score? So you need to have at least a unique key on the basis of which you will fetch the item back. So let's say we are using ID over here. So let's say ID is a 1, 2, 3. So what we will do is, let's say we will store actually a hash table. Let's say a hash table is just an array, and array has indexes, let's say 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on up to, let's say, k buckets. We decide k bucket array, and whenever a new ID comes for insertion, what we will do is we will pick the ID from there and we will mod it with k. So that is our hash function now. So user 1 comes in, our k is, let's say, 10 buckets. So one comes in, we will take the item from here and we will put the item over here. So let's say this comes here. We have ID number 1. Dev comes in, we will use bucket number 2 and we will put Dev over here. Piyush comes in, we will use bucket number 3 and we will put Piyush over here. Now when the get call comes in, we will again use the same hash table and the same hash function to get the item back. So for example, let's say we have to update the score for Devansh, and so we will just use 2 mod k, which is 10, which is again 2, and we will know at this 2 bucket we will have Devansh. What will be the complexity? Let's say order hash function is order 1, since it's just doing a modulo operation. So insertion will be again order of 1, and fetching will be again a query. Be again order of 1. This is the best case scenario. You are able to perform both the operations of insertion and query in order 1. But what will happen, let's say if some user comes in with ID number, let's say 12. Let's say a user with name Rajiv comes in with ID number 12. So again you will do the same operation, mod 10. So 12 mod 10 becomes 2. You will go to node number 2, and what you will find is somebody is already present here. Either you will rewrite over it, or you will just not write Raji, right? So this particular problem is called collision. When you whenever you are using hash table and you reach a particular bucket, these are called, actually each one of the cell is called a bucket in hashing. So whenever you find a bucket and you find that something is already written in that bucket, so that is called collision. And how do you solve collision? There are multiple ways to solve collision. One of the ways is going further in the bucket. So for example, let's say whenever you land on node number 2 or bucket number 2, you will find like something is already written over there, so you will not stop. What you will try to do is you will go to the next bucket. So you will land at number 2, so you go to number 3, and at 3 you find again there is something ready, which is Piyush, so you will again go to next node and you will find like 4 is free, so you will just put Rajiv over here. Similarly, when you are searching for the particular item, you will start from this node, let's say you have 2, and you will find whether the ID of the item matches over here or not, so you will also store the ID, let's say 2 or ID number 12. So whenever you are searching for ID number 12, you will go to node number 2 first, because that's the hash function that gives you bucket number 2. You find the ID number, ID present at bucket number 2 is ID number 2. So you are looking for ID number 12. So you go to the next node, you find the ID number stored over here is 3. Then you go to the next node, you find ID stored over here is 12, and that's the one you are looking for. So you will return the data from this particular bucket. This will work fine. And what is the worst case complexity in this case? Let's say you always land on a single bucket, and always you have to go one by one. So in this case, insertion will be order of n. Similarly for searching, let's say you again will, let's say in the worst case you will land at one at single bucket, and you will have to go to each of the bucket one by one, so order of n again. This is the worst case scenario. Even we were at least better with arrays using just single list. This actually has one more problem, which is let's say you have little 10 buckets. So how many items maximum can you fill over here? You can only fill 10 items, right? If you have, let's say 10 items, all the buckets are filled, you will not be able to fill more items over here. That's an even bigger issue, because you had, let's 1000 items and you wanted to put them in the hash table, but you can fill only 10 items. From the 11th item, you will just keep on working and you will not be able to find any empty bucket to store. So there are two problems to solve. One is the problem of the increased complexity of insertion and deletion, insertion and query. And the second problem is the storage. Your storage is getting used up very quickly. So how do we solve this? Is, let's say we are using so instead of storing the item right at the bucket, what we will do is we will store a list, or a linked list at the particular bucket. So for example, let's say this is the bucket, let's say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. So at each node, instead of storing a value directly, you will store a list. So how will this work out? If let's say you get only that node number 2, so you will store only over here. You get Devansh at node number 3, you will store Devansh at here. Now let's say you get Rajiv at ID number 12, so it will have 2 bucket number 2, So you will go to bucket number 2 and you will find that there is something already written over here. But instead of overriding or going further in the buckets, you will add Rajiv on that particular node in that list itself. So whenever you get a collision, you will update the list instead of going further in the buckets. So this way you will be able to store as many number of items that you want. But what's the complexity looks like? You just solve the storage problem, and let's see what's the complexity. The complexity, let's say in the worst case, again you store single item, you store item at one node only. So order, but still since you are storing at the end, so it will be order of one. You will use the hash function to reach a bucket, and then you will directly store the item at the end of the list. So this will be order one. What will be the query time? Query time will be, in the worst case, you will all of your items are present in a single bucket, and that's why you will have to go from 1 second, third, fourth. So you will have to iterate n items at a time. So order of n will be your search complexity. It's still better than this, but not better than this, right? Here we were anyways getting order of one insertion, order of n insertion in this particular guy. So why are we doing this? So what happens in your practical scenario? Okay, so let's first see how you can improve this. This is the worst case, right? So how you can improve this is, you can, instead of storing a list over here, what you can do is you can actually store a binary tree or binary search tree, or I would say balanced binary search tree over here. So whenever you insert a value, whenever there is a collision and you start storing the same data on a single node, you will, instead of using a list, you will use a binary search tree, and that binary search tree is also balanced. You can use AV trees or red black trees, whatever you want to use, but this balanced binary tree is there so that you are able to maintain the complexity to order log n. So what will happen is, whenever you want to, let's say you get 2 over here, so let's say Udit gets inserted over here, then Rajiv over here, then Ajit over here. And this way you will store your keys or your IDs or whatever in this particular structure, so that when you query them back in the worst case, or when the number of collisions become high, you will not have order n complexity. Instead of that, you will have order log n complexity. How will that work is, let's say you want to insert. Let's see what's the complexity for these. So let's say you want to insert, you reach a particular bucket via using hash function. Let's say you want to insert node number ID number 12. So you get come at here. Let's say you have 22, and let's say the name is Sonali. So you mod 2, which is becomes 2. So you come at bucket number 2. You want to now, since there is a tree, you will insert the new data into this tree, and insertion in a binary search tree takes order log n. So insertion here takes order of log n time. Similarly, when you are searching for a particular key, you will come to that particular bucket, and again you will search for that key in the tree. So searching in a binary search tree also takes order log n time. Here, you have improved your query time, but you have increased your insertion time from here. Here you are getting order 1, here you are getting order log n. Here you are getting query time as order n, and here order log n. So which one do you want to use, right? It's very confusing now. You reduce your query time, but you are increasing your insertion time. So that is a trade-off that you want to see, whether you are seeing more number of insertions in your data that you are going to use, whether you want to improve the query time. So whatever you want to improve, you have to use the that particular technology as per your convenience. If you already know that your query times will be 100x than your insertions, then obviously having a data structure, having a backend data structure, having more query time is of no use, right? So you will go ahead with binary search tree. But if you know your insertions are way higher, then you might want to use this particular hashing mechanism. Interestingly, the same mechanism is also used by Java hash maps. So if you have ever gone into the code of Java hash maps, they are also using hashing only. So how do they work? Is which one do you think they will use, either this one or this one? Because they do not know what your use case is. So how will they optimize for your use case? Just think about it once. Okay, so how they will they work actually is they basically use a mix of both. So until a particular the length of the list at a particular bucket is small enough that they think is smaller than a threshold. So they think up to a threshold the complexity or length complexity of iterating through the list stays constant. So for example, if you have, let's say, 10 as a threshold, so going through 10 items is a constant thing, right? You are not iterating through n number of items. You are iterating through 10 items at max. So iterating through up to a threshold stays constant, right? That's what assumption they have made. So until your list stays at up to 10, they will keep a list over here. I mean, I'm just saying 10, I'm just assuming the number, but up to a threshold T, they will keep a list at a particular bucket. For each of the bucket, they will keep that threshold. And whichever bucket exceeds that threshold, they will convert that list to a binary search tree at that particular bucket. So that, since you know, your query time will increase only when the size of the list increases, right? If your sizes of the list are not increasing, that means if you are not having many collisions, then there is no point maintaining a binary search tree and having higher insertion complexity. You can have lower insertion complexity if there are no or very less collisions. So because of that, until the size of the list is small enough that it can be considered as a constant time to query the list, they keep it as list, and whenever the size of the list goes above threshold, they will convert into binary search tree. Yeah, so that's how Java HashMaps work. It's a pretty common interview question which people ask, like how Java HashMaps work internally. So this is the answer. You they first keep list and then they convert into binary search tree dynamically depending on the size of the list at a particular bucket. And this happens per bucket basis, right? It is not for a full list. So even if, let's say, this particular bucket has, let's say, 100 items, so only binary search tree will be created for this particular bucket. If this has, let's say, only 2 items, it will again still be a list. So it's a combination of both in Java Maps. So yeah, that's it from hashing and Java Maps. Tell me about your feedback or any comments that you have in the comment section below. I will try to incorporate those comments in my future videos.